Well, here I am. Pulled up. I got the rockers with me. What's up, Rocky? Quit eating grass, buddy. Yeah, I'm way back in the middle of nowhere, man. I mean, the trees are just now starting to bud. They're just now starting to bud. And these are poplar trees, aspens. And we get pine trees. I pulled up and I got out of the car right here. I was standing right there and I called home. Barely got any service. I don't know how I had service. And I was talking to Alicia and I heard a deer back here snort me. So I walked up on the hill here, and it's gorgeous up here. I walked up and I looked way back there on that far hill. She's about 100 yards away and she's just standing, big old doe, just looking at me like, what are you doing on my property? Get on out of here. But she took off. She just moseyed off. It's not like she was scared too bad. But I hope tonight or in the morning to hear some coyotes howling and barking off in the woods and stuff. But there is a ton of wintergreen plants. Now, they can fool you sometimes. Sometimes we got plants up here, it looks just like wintergreen. The way you test a wintergreen, you don't test the berry, you test the leaf. You pluck the leaf and you chew on the leaf. So the leaf tastes like wintergreen. Then it's wintergreen. Of course, you spit it back out, but you can chew on the leaves. It doesn't hurt you at all. But actually, that's the first berry I've seen right there. So I don't have too much time to look. We had a frost, so it might have, it doesn't look that good of a berry. So they're all over the ground. But maybe when they really come on, this would be a good place to come. I've seen red. The whole hill's covered. It's just green, carpeted with them. So, and these look like blueberry bushes right here. Right here. These look like blueberry bushes. So, I'm going to have to check this out later on. Mid, late July is when blueberries are good. So, 1st of August. So, I got to get the rest of my camp ready. Someone had already built the bonfire here. So, we get rowdies out here at night tearing up stuff. So, I don't know. That's all right, but there's my tent. That's the 10x10 teepee. It's kind of awkward looking right now, but I got a shorter stick in there and holding up the top. But it's 10x10, the 18x18 just too big for me, one person. So, but Rocky's around back there. Hey, Rock. Come here, buddy. Oh, tripping over the guide wires. What's up? What you doing, bud? Huh? What you doing? I'm having a good time. Chasing squirrels? Are you chasing squirrels? All right. I got to get everything, my backpack out and everything else, and then get Woodford bonfire. Looks like we got to start there, so. Talk to you later. Bye. Right. Got some things going. Take an extra 10% off already reduced mattresses from my Sanjeen 909X shortwave world band radio. I don't know if you can see this, but we have an external antenna. Alright, get this. Tonight we'll be I'll show you some Chinese and some Russian channels that I pick up. But antenna goes, it's a wire antenna, goes into this tree right here. And it goes all the way up. I don't know if you can see it. The end of it, that big black thing way up there. The sun's kind of in my face, but it goes way up there. And man, I can pick up Russian channels, all kind of channels. And we'll get some tonight. Chinese, Japanese, get a lot of South American, Guatemala, all kind of stuff. Different languages. And some are in English. So But I gotta get busy here. I got everything put up. You see the windows here. And I got my sleeping bag up in there and stuff up in there. So I'm ready to go. I just need to gather some wood. That Gerber machete is nice, man. Nice. This wood's still green. I thought it was dead than what it was, but evidently it broke over the winter time. Hadn't had a chance to dry out yet. Ain't no good for a fire. We'll find something else. There's even more dead stuff over here. There we go. Got me. Gonna boil some water here in my stainless steel up here. There we go. I made this stove myself. It's two tin cans inside the other, and the outside can's got holes in the bottom, and the inside can has also got holes in the bottom, and the air flows up, and it's kind of like a jet stove. And I bought some wire fencing at like Tractor Supply, made a little top for it, and it'll heat up my water for me. Didn't cost me hardly anything. The wood's kind of wet, so we had all this rain, it's kind of hard to get her going, but it's going. Getting a lot of soot because it's wet. Normally with dry oak, this thing just burns like a rocket, man. It heats water in just a couple minutes. I mean, it'll be boiling in just a couple minutes, but this wood's so wet. I should have brought some with me, but it's all right. It also makes biochar. I make my own charcoal for my charcoal filters for my water purifier. Because the wood's not burning. The wood that's down inside of it ain't burning. It's degassing. And the gas goes through the holes in the center can, comes between the two walls of the cans, comes up, and there's some holes on the top inside. And it jets out. And at nighttime, you'll be able to see it real good. It's like a gas stove. And it burns the smoke. It's pretty neat. It's a bio stove. I got the designs off the internet, and it works really well. So it won't be long with a good flame like we're going now, and I'll have some nice hot water for my mountain house meal. Old Rocker, he don't know what to think. He's like, man, I've never been camping before, but this is cool. Just taking on all the sights and sounds and stuff. Looking for something to chase. Okay. She's really heating up. She's starting to steam on the inside. I got the lid kind of... It's a plastic lid, so I got to be careful with it. But if you don't keep the lid on it, it takes a lot longer to heat up. So, but I dug out some beef stew. Mountain House. And... single serving. I got some double servings in there. I got chicken teriyaki with rice. I got all kind of stuff. I got beef stroganoff, you name it. Spaghetti. Got it all. So, and there actually I got 2 weeks worth of it inside the pack in the bottom. But I didn't feel like taking it out on the way here. Because since I was driving here, I didn't have to pack it in the woods. I just kept it in there. But beef stew. We're going to have some beef stew here in a little while. Be right back. Okay. Hey, Rockums. I poured the water in there. Boy, it reconstituted fast. It's a lot of beef stew. Boy, did it smell good.
So just put it in there and let it stir it, and then set the zip seal back and wait a few minutes and then eat it. I'm gonna give Rocky some. You want some too, don't you, buddy? Yeah. You do, huh? Yeah. Him want beef stew? Yeah, I want beef stews. Crazy nut. Yeah, you having fun, buddy? Having fun? Yeah. Keep out an eye out for critters. Yeah. Alright. Be back in a minute. Okay. Boy, man, there's a lot in there. Piping hot. Boy, it looks so good and it smells so good. Wow. It is hot. Boy, does it smell good. I'm starving. I'm gonna eat. Bye. Oh, you like that, do ya? You bag? You like it, bag? Huh? You want some more of that beef stew? Come on. Come on. There we go. Oh, please. Please, please. Oh, please. Please, please, please. Bag. Oh, I want some beef stews. Here we go. There we go. Let's put in your dish here. There you go, buddy. There you go. Eat it up. He says, ooh, yeah, I like that. Onions and carrots and peas and potatoes and beef. Oh, excuse me.
Ralph.
Oh. I think I might go take my sling of David that I made. Go get some stones and start slinging some stones. Test these out. Get back with you later. Pigging out. Now, this I believe is Spanish.
No necesita yo creo para nada.
No, no, yo no quería decir que lo necesite.
Reivindicará.
Digo que a Gran Bretaña le venía muy bien que lo reforzara.
Bueno, si le viene bien la notoriedad, con
y que
la autoridad
haga expresión expresa.
Casar al nieto de la reina, pues también la notoriedad pública.
I was on a Spain channel a while ago. It said directly from Spain, but it was in English, which was pretty cool. So I'm picking up all over the
this
world.
This one kind of sounds like Serbian or something.
Nós nessas situações em que há reação negativa ao novo sabor, à nova textura do alimento, a solução é ir continuando a expor o alimento, colocar na mesa, noutras refeições, continuar a expor a criança ao alimento, colocar no prato dela, mesmo que ela não coma, e manter esta abordagem, esta atitude.
Okay, here's Beijing, here's Chinese National Radio in English. This one, I have it written down, and now I found it again. So it's Beijing. It's Beijing, out of Beijing, Chinese National Radio.
Vine 16, Sydney sunny 19, Wellington sunny 14, Perth clear 34, Cairo clear 36, Monrovia sunny 31, and finally Nairobi will be sunny with a high of 26. Before we go, a reminder of the main stories. Nominee for the next U.S. ambassador to China, Gary Locke, vows to boost U.S.-China ties and expand...
Okay, you're not going to believe this. I found that wacko who said that God was going to return and, you know, last Friday or Saturday, something like that. I found his radio program. It's on shortwave band 11530. And, guess what? He set another date. October 21st. And here's this guy.
False prophecy. You all spent millions of dollars.
He's taking calls from callers. And he's just such a wacko.
Sorry that we didn't have the...
That's him.
We didn't have the whole truth yet. I'm very sorry for those who... have had difficulties as a result of that. It's very sad that this happened. But you know, the fact is that everything that we have done was done as honestly as is possible. It was not done for money. It was not done
for... Oh, what a liar. People gave him everything, and they sold everything and gave it to him.
That one guy who sold his savings and everything and paid for all the billboards to promote this thing. Oh, come on. Give me a break, guys. I can't listen to this guy anymore. Well, I'm going to look for a different channel. You never know what I'm going to find out here.
Well, it's 6 in the morning, and we made it through. I'm about to run out of juice in this video camera. But the coyotes last night kept me up quite a bit. A whole pack of them back there just in the woods, just going at it. Yelping and screaming and hollering all night long. Chasing stuff. And then we got a ruffed grouse, two or three of them back in the woods here, beating their chest on a log, trying to call in a mate. It sounds like old John Deere tractor cranking up in the morning time. But you won't be able to hear it on here, but I can hear it. In fact, it's what woke me up this morning. Beating on their chest. It was crazy. Rough growls. This place is wild out here, man. But 6 in the morning, and it rained last night a little bit, but I'm dry as a bone. Hehe.
I never let you see. I keep it caged, but I can't control it. So stay away from me. The beast is ugly. I feel the rage and I just can't hold it. It's scratching on the wall, in the closet, in the halls. It comes awake and I can't control it. Hiding under the bed, in my body, in my head. Why won't somebody come and save me from this? Make it in.
Come out from under the car. Come here. They're all out, sir. Come on, baby. I know that hurts. Especially in your sensitive little nosy. You're very fortunate there were tiny quills. Rocky's a very aggressive dog. He will catch critters. You know, he might run away from a big dog, but he won't run away from wild animals very easy. He'll attack, man. As small as he is, he was designed to dig badgers out of holes. Badgers are ferocious, so I know his nosy hurts, right? He's laying down. Little eyes are glazed over. But you gotta know how to do that kind of stuff when you're out in the woods. I mean, there's no way I was gonna leave him in his nose and take him to the vet and all that. Because they'd have done the exact same thing I did, just pull him out one by one. And the last two were directly in his nose, and that's a sensitive area. I figured just get both of them at the same time, and I did. And I snatched every one of them. I just yanked real quick, you know, just pow, really quick, so that they came right out. Boy, that's gotta hurt. I couldn't imagine. But he's so fortunate they weren't in his eyes and in his ears and stuff. But the porcupines, what they do when an animal gets real close, they jerk really fast and force themselves into the animal. And Rocky, I guarantee he got close with his nose, and then that tail swap, bam, and got him right in the nose, because the tail's got small quills in them. He's doing good. He's sniffing around. He'll be fine. But there's quills. I mean, those things got quills, you know, this long on them. Okay, he's very fortunate. I mean, I'm gonna kill him. You know. So, he's very fortunate. He had just them little dinky ones in there. So, Rocky's pretty quick. That's probably why he didn't get any more in him than what he did. He's around sniffing, so he's gonna be fine. All right, let's go home, Rocky. You've had enough. Come here. Let's go by. Kennel. There you go. All right. Get out of here.